The school didn't seem to have anything they could do to make it better. To explain to him what it was he was doing was very wrong. So Dad took it into his own hands. He built a section of fence in his backyard. He told his son, every time that he heard his son use a derogatory name, an epithet, or something bad said by an individual or a group of people, he would have to hammer nails into that piece of fence. After about 30 days, he got pretty tired of hammering nails in that fence. So it began to decrease. The incidents decreased. Pretty soon they weren't happening at all anymore. Then the dad said, I'm so proud of you for changing your attitude and your language. Now every time you compliment someone or a group, they want you to remove nails from the section of fence. So he got so excited by being able to do this and seeing the proof of his progress that he began to compliment and praise, and he just had a better life. He was not always involved in the darkness of hate and discrimination. Pretty soon all the nails were gone out of the fence. His dad was very proud of him. He took his son into the backyard, and they were standing before the section of fence. And he said, I want you to look at this piece of fence. First you nail the hammers in, then you remove the nails from the fence. But see what's left? We'll never be able to get rid of those holes made by those nails. These holes represent the scars that you've created on all those individuals that you've derided by calling them names or shouting epithets at them. Those holes will never heal. Those scars will never go away. This is a visual for me that is so profound. Because once you become a member of that category, you really sometimes never escape. That derision lives with you forever. Forever. I hope you understand that this part of your life is like a blip in your life and seems very important to you right now. And it is for your growth and development and maturity. But you become adults, and then you become parents. And are you the kind of child you want to have? It's about understanding and acceptance. It's not about tolerance. We tolerate bad hair days, not people. It's about acceptance and even celebration. I've been doing this almost 10 years, and I don't work with notes, so I sometimes have a problem transitioning between the program and questions, and so the best I've been able to do is just let you know that now we're going to do questions. I don't see microphones.